Now, in this lecture, we will study something very interesting, which is Heisenberg's boxes. For that, let me tell you what actually this means. This is time. This is frequency. I take a window. Let me take a Gaussian window. Okay. Which is T G of T. Now, if I want to see how this window, this Gaussian window, is translated, if I want to say that translate in time to you and frequency to zeta, that means that I have to in some sense translate this g of t such that it is placed somewhere here at u, centered at u in time and centered at zeta in frequency. Now how can we do this? In a sense that if I take g of omega or the Fourier transform of this, of some modified version of it, let me tell I modify g t to some g dash t. If I take its Fourier transform, then g dash omega must be centered around some sort of zeta, or it must be something like this. Let me draw. That this is somewhere here in time and this is somewhere here in frequency. Now, and this is what we represent as Heisenberg's box, where there is some sort of variance here and variance in frequency here. Okay, but now, first of all, what I am trying to say, let me give you an integral feel of what I am writing. If I want to translate in time by u, what will I do? Let me take g of t minus u, because I am translating it in time. What will be its frequency transform, Fourier transform then? Remember, I want to tell you a shortcut of how to do this. G of t convolved with delta of t minus u is what we tell it as. G of t minus u, and convolution in time domain becomes multiplication in frequency domain. So this becomes multiplication, g of t becomes g of omega, delta of t minus u will become, what is the Fourier transform of delta of t minus u? Simply the value of e raised to the power minus g omega t at u, which is nothing but e raised to the power minus j omega u. This is what will be the Fourier transform of this signal. But this, if I take the frequency spectrum of this signal, then where will it be centered? It will be centered at u in this what we tell time, but it will center somewhere at zero in frequency. It won't be centered at zeta. So just to make it centered at zeta, I do a process where I translate it by zeta here. And whenever I translate it, what will happen? I can write it sort of a translation by zeta as convolution with delta of omega minus zeta. Are you getting it? Because whenever I multiply by omega minus zeta, this whole stuff will get this will get shifted to zeta, this whole stuff, what I am trying to say. So, in other sense, what will happen is that I sort of omega minus zeta, the whole thing. This will happen, or whenever I translate it by zeta, this will get multiplied with e raised to the power. This time, because it is in frequency, e raised to the power, what is the formula? F of t is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integration, some stuff, where e raised to the power j omega t comes. So if I put this theta here, then what will I get? I will get nothing but multiplication with j zeta e raised to the power j zeta t. So if I look at what actually it's happening, is that if I want to represent something, now forget everything. If I tell you that take this cell, g of t minus u e raised to the power j zeta t. Where is it centered in time? In time, this just take mod of it. Where is it centered? It is centered at u, simply. You can see. If I take Fourier transform, then this is g of omega minus zeta. And this becomes this t minus u if I take e raised to the power j minus j omega u. Now where is this absolute value of this sort of centered in frequency? It is centered at this zeta. So in this sense, if I take some sort of this kind of a window, this numerical understanding actually means that this window is translated in time by u and translated in frequency by zeta. So you must understand the significance of what this means. And if I draw an interesting diagram of what is happening, let me draw the diagram. This g of t minus u, this is g of omega minus zeta, and this is g of t minus u times e raised to the power j zeta t. This is g of, let me take this capital because this has become frequency, omega minus zeta e raised to the power minus j omega u. Now what I am trying to say is that whenever I take this translate this signal with frequency, or whenever I multiply by e raised to the power minus omega u, then multiplication will lead to translation in frequency. And whenever I multiply this signal, which is in frequency, with e raised to the power j zeta t, so this multiplication with this will lead to, this is translation in frequency. And this multiplication in this what we tell frequency will lead to translation in time. So in that sense, we take this, we have to understand that why this g of t minus u e raised to the power minus j omega u is this important, and why this g of this capital G, or I'm sorry, I should write this as capital because this is time, I'm sorry, this capital G, which is in frequency domain, this is in FD, gets transformed into this in time domain, translation in time. So in that sense, I have given a complete picture of what I wanted to say. And now let us understand what a spectrogram means. So whenever I take a signal, multiply by such window. Let me tell that window, it's not necessary Gaussian, as g of u comma zeta is equal to g of t minus u e raised to the power minus j zeta t, such window. Then, and this window has to have two properties at least. First, the first and essential property of this window is that it must be symmetrical. In sense, g of minus t is equal to g of t. And this, the second property which it must satisfy is that it must have a unit norm, second order norm. Because otherwise it will introduce some sort of a scaling, and in this case it will introduce some sort of an ambiguity. So this is very important. So whenever I take some sort of whenever I multiply the signal FT with this stuff g of u comma zeta and take the Fourier transform or multiply or integrate it some sort of way, then what I do get is nothing but a short time Fourier transform. So what are we doing essentially is we are taking a dot product of this FT with let me say for now this g of u comma zeta. Why I remove this minus? I intentionally remove this minus because in dot product we take a conjugate, and that's why, to just get it similar to what is frequency transform, frequency analog, I remove this minus, so that whenever I take this dot product, this conjugate becomes minus, which is more intuitive and is the correct way of representation. So in that sense, whenever I take this FT, this GT, and I take this dot product, if you are not comfortable, take this g dash t which was minus and now this gts which is plus, okay? So in that sense, this dot product gives me what we call short time Fourier transform, which is at u in time and zeta in frequency. So in that sense, what is STFT is clear, and this STFT will look something like this. Time is here, this is frequency, and at particular time u and particular frequency zeta, there will be some value which I will get by dot product with this. This function will be representative of the three-dimensional plot. And if I take this square of this modulus square of SF of u comma zeta and plot it in time and frequency, what I get is nothing but spectrogram. So what I get is spectrogram. You have some command in MATLAB to plot it directly, spec or something like that, I don't remember it exactly, but you can simply plot it in a way that you get some colored form of representation. So now by this we conclude this lecture.